Without you, I fall apart. You're the one that guides my heart. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my righteousness. Oh, God, how I need you. My sin runs deep.
Good morning and welcome to Prayer and Devotion on this Monday, August 24th. Starting off with I Need You, Lord by Matt Marr. Right in line, it was exactly the song I needed to hear. Actually woke up with it on my heart as I woke up this morning. So I hope that it was a blessing for you as well. It is good to be with you today, friends. Good morning, Renetta and Siege. Good morning, Vinette. Good morning, Betty. Good morning, Andrea. Good morning, Marilyn. And good morning, Ingrid. Holding each one of you in prayer this morning. This morning, we are looking at our devotion is entitled Consumed by Cravings. Consumed by Cravings. And the scripture we're going to be looking at is a familiar scripture from the book of Psalms, and it is Psalm 84. So I invite you to get your Bibles out so you can follow along. We're going to look at Psalm 84, verses 1 through 2. And as you're getting your Bibles out, if this is your first time here, I want to welcome you. My name is Cindy Sauper. I am blessed to serve as the pastor at the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick, and we gather here every morning at 6:30, and so I am so glad to be with you this morning. So Psalm 84, chapter 84, verses 1 through 2, tells us the following. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord of hosts. My soul longs, indeed it faints, for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh sing for joy to the living God. It's short enough, so I'm going to read it again. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord of hosts. My soul longs, indeed it faints, for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh sing for joy to the living God. And this is what our devotion today says about Psalm 84. A few years ago, a weight loss company came up with a brilliant advertising campaign. Maybe some of you saw their ads. There's a little orange monster who chases a woman around, tempting and taunting her with foods that obviously aren't a part of her healthy eating plan. And these ads perfectly capture what it feels like to be harassed by cravings all day long. Well, I've never seen this orange monster chasing me. I've felt its presence. I've felt it for food cravings, but I know that we all feel it for something. Sometimes many somethings. Attention and satisfaction, like me. Approval and appreciation, follow me. Money and power, give me more, more, more. And sometimes it feels like the chase will never end, the cravings will never be filled, that nothing will ever be enough. While the orange monster is a great way to visualize the cravings, those ads fell short in their promise to really help this woman. The weight loss company's theory is to teach what foods are more filling and encourage the consumption of those. But does that really help overcome cravings? We shop and spend money on things we don't need. We still eat the chocolate pie when we're full from our dinner. We scroll through social media, checking our pages and counting our likes and comments. We indulge in our guilty pleasures, hide our secret sins, and lie in bed wondering if this is it. Is this all there is? What is actually going on here? I believe God made us to crave. Now, before you think this is some sort of cruel joke by God, let me assure you that the object of our craving was never supposed to be food or the many other things people themselves find themselves consumed by. Think about the definition of the word craving. How would you define it? Dictionary.com defines craving as something you long for, want greatly, desire eagerly, and beg for. Now, consider this expression of craving. How lovely is your dwelling place, Lord Almighty. My soul yearns, even faints, for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. Yes, we were made to crave, to long for, to want greatly, to desire eagerly, and beg for God, only God. Does this resonate with you? Have you chosen to pursue God, to follow Jesus? He created you to know Him, to be fulfilled more deeply by knowing God than by any other experience or pleasure this world has to offer. When we admit our need for God, when we humble ourselves and confess our sins and ask God to be the Lord of our lives, that's where the journey begins. God saves us in that moment, and then we can begin the process of allowing God to fulfill our cravings and make us eternally, completely, and wholly filled. Is it easy? No. Is it worth it? 1,000 times yes. Yeah, so we talked a little bit about this on Saturday as well. These cravings that keep us moving towards things, hoping that the next thing will fill us up. And I, like the author, am definitely food is my big issue. Always challenging, and the worst part is like when you know you're eating things to fill you up, right? Afterwards, you may feel full, but you don't feel well. And that's, like, okay, so I'm no longer hungry, but I feel horrible. Like, I don't feel the way that I think God intends for me to feel. And when I remember that, the other day I was busy. I think that's another craving thing, or craving to be busy all the time. But I was doing something and I thought to myself this same thing, like, why is this not satisfying me? Why do I feel so unsatisfied at this moment? And I realized that day I had not reconnected with God. And in that moment, I just stopped and I took a really deep breath. And, in the words of the song, I cried out, "I need you, Lord." And in that moment, there's peace. I realized all these other things will never be able to fill me with the peace that comes with being present with God. And Jesus needed that too. I mean, like, whenever he was being really, when he had major decisions to make, when he was being pulled in so many directions, he knew, or even as he's facing death, right? He knew he needed that time in prayer. He needed only the peace that comes from a connection with God, a deeper connection. That is the only thing that will ever truly satisfy our hearts. All these other things, and food's not a bad thing. We eat food, but when we use food as a way to heal ourselves, right? Or to make ourselves feel better. When we use drugs and alcohol as a way to kind of numb the deep emotions that we may be feeling. When we use relationships to give us the love that we think we deserve. When we use work to keep us distracted from the things that are important, we are left feeling empty inside, not filled up. Work is a good thing. Food is a good thing. It's not even bad to have a small glass of wine. But when these things become a tool to fill us, they will always leave us feeling empty. It is only in our deeper connection with God that we will find true satisfaction. And so today, my friend, what are the things that you are craving after? And yesterday in church we talked about often these addictions keep us bound. We feel like there's no way to break free. But perhaps today you might be able to bring whatever it is that's keeping you bound to the foot of the cross and say, "Jesus, I need you. I need you. I need you more than these. I need your power to give me through the next day. My one defense, my righteousness. Oh God, I need you." Let us pray. Lord, we need you. We acknowledge that too often we have gone down our own paths. We have chased after things that we think will fill us up only to feel emptier and emptier. We long to be in your presence. Our souls yearn for you alone. And so we come to you today and we lay at your feet all of those things that have kept us bound, that have kept us from you, that have occupied our time and our strength, that have left us empty. Lord, we give all of this to you and we ask for the freedom that you offer. Lay your hands on us this day and help us to feel the true filling, the true wholeness, the true satisfaction that comes from knowing that we are your beloved children. Help us this day whenever we are feeling lost or empty or broken down to turn to you again. To cry out, even if it's just in a small voice inside, to cry out, Lord, we need you. Lord, I lift up everyone on the call today, whatever it is that they may be walking through, whatever addictions that have kept them bound, Lord, I pray that your freedom, your healing, your strength, your grace will fall on them in powerful ways today. And that they may truly feel the peace that you bring that passes all understanding. We lift all of this to you, Lord Jesus, as together we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Have a blessed day. My prayer for each of you today is that you experience the freedom and the wholeness that comes with a walk with the Lord. God loves you, my friends, and so do I. I will see you tomorrow. Bye.